Yep, so that telco's bad. Pretty simple, huh?
Sure is, Pinky. But what about...
Well, hey, boys, what are you up to this morning?
Really? Hey, Mr. Adams.
Nothing. Up to nothing in particular, but yeah.
Oh, I was just wondering if you boys like to hear an interesting Bible story this morning.
I didn't know Mr. Adams could read. Story. Sure, we love stories.
Think for yourself, Bob. I'd rather play a video game. You got any, Mr. Adams?
No. Sorry, Stinky. No video games in worship, but I do have this story. And if you want, it can be an interactive, just like the video game.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, well, many years before Jesus...
Wait. Was born.
What is it, Stinky?
Well, isn't the story supposed to start out with once upon a time?
Okay, if you say so. Once upon a time, many years before Jesus was born, the prophet Isaiah wrote, "A voice shouting in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God."
Shouting? My mom says I should never shout in the house. But she probably wouldn't care if I shouted in the wilderness.
But there's no one to shout in at the wilderness. The guy must have been crazy.
Hold on. Let me continue the story.
Are there going to be any dragons or ogres in the story? I don't like stories with dragons and ogres.
No, Stinky.
Well, go ahead. I want to see what happens to this crazy guy who shouted in the wilderness.
Well, this guy who shouted in the wilderness actually came many years later. His name was John the Baptist.
John the Baptist? I thought this was a Lutheran church. Well, he wasn't that
kind of Baptist. They called him John the Baptist because he spent a lot of time baptizing people in the Jordan River. He was the one God told to get the road or highway ready for Jesus' coming.
He had to get the road ready all by himself? Kind of a big job for one guy. Plus, he had a bulldozer.
That's cool. I'm a big fan of bulldozers.
No, I'm afraid there were no bulldozers. You see, John the Baptist was getting the road ready in a different way than you guys are thinking of. God told him to get people's hearts ready. The straight road would be in their hearts.
Road in somebody's heart? Bet that hurts.
Who cares if it hurts? I'm no sissy. Say, Mr. Adams, can I get one of those straight roads in my heart?
No. Let me tell you the rest of the story, and, well, we'll see if you still want one. John was a man who lived out in the wilderness. He was so busy worshiping and talking to God that he didn't take time to earn money for food and clothes like everyone else.
So he couldn't buy clothes. So, like, was he naked?
No. He was dressed in animal skins that he had found. And he ate, well, whatever he could easily find. And that was locusts and wild honey. And crowds of people came to the wilderness to see him.
Wait, locusts? Those are big. He ate big bugs?
Big bugs with honey on
them. Yeah.
Yeah, no kidding. But, hey, you said people came to see in Europe. What did he have to say to everyone?
Well, God had a very special message for John the Baptist to give to the people. He wanted John to tell everyone to turn away from their sins and be baptized so that their hearts could be ready to accept Jesus when he came.
Oh, I get it now. A heart free from guilt is like a straight road ready to welcome Jesus. So, can I get one of those roads in my heart?
Well, do you want one, C.G.?
I do.
Sure, I'll take one too. But hold the bugs with honey. Still got.
Well, the good news is that we can all ask for God's forgiveness and have a straight road for Jesus in our hearts. God has promised that, and well, when we confess our sins, he will take away the guilt from our sins. And that's the most important thing we can do. To pray for God and ask for his help.
I think we better get going. We've got some praying to do.
Lots and lots of praying. But wait, how does the story end, Mr. Adams? Are you sure there's no dragons or ogres?
No, there are no dragons or ogres. But if you want to see how the story ends, you and Bob need to ask God to help you make a straight road for Jesus in your heart. Once that happens, I'm sure the story's going to get very interesting.
Yeah, sure, Mr. Adams. We'll see you around, okay?
Yeah, we'll let you know how it goes, all right? All right, see ya. Over and out, whatever.